All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome in. Nick, David, Clint. Welcome.
To Baker Go Home. Baker Go Home.
Baker Go Home.
Jason Isbell in the 400 unit is better than Morgan Wallen.
I mean,
there's a hot take.
I'm not going to debate that. I don't know if he wants me to while I eat my homemade cinnamon roll.
I feel like that's unprofessional, so I'm going to set this to the side. I promise it's a glandular problem.
Hey, these cinnamon rolls are unbelievable. They're fantastic. They're delicious.
1,000,000% homemade, by the way. Love and 6 hours of work.
Yeah, that when you brought them, hey, when you brought them that first time, they were fantastic. These are fantastic.
Yeah, do we want to openly acknowledge how we got here?
Yes, absolutely, because it makes part of the story.
Well, my mom and dad.
Good job. I don't think we mean that story of how we got here.
You don't have to be graphic about it. We're good.
Hey, these are great.
I think you meant how we got here today, not here as
I drove.
Baby.
I don't know.
No way, me too.
Well, full disclosure.
I'm writing down my recommendation. That's why. Okay. Sorry.
Full disclosure. This is actually a retake, not a retake, but a retake.
We're leaning into it.
Yeah. Well, we messed up here. There are such things as technical difficulties here on the show. And what exactly was it? Somebody's mic wasn't on? No. The mics were overlapped.
There were two channels of audio or something going into the mixer, and so it.
Anyway,
there was an echo.
So there was video, but there was a major, major echo, and so we couldn't do.
Oh my god!
Yeah, that's great. So we couldn't use the show. So
that's
awesome. Bad news is, we had to do this twice. The good news is we got twice the baked goods. So
it's true. And cinnamon goods at that.
Exactly.
Last time was cinnamon roll cookies.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Hey, now
these are great.
The red velvet cookies.
Yeah.
They're some of my favorites. But what that red velvet cookie that you made with the, what was inside of that? That you told me to warm up. I did warm it up, and it was
the strawberry one.
Yeah.
It was a cream cheese.
Yeah, that was great too.
The love of children.
That was great.
She came in. Was that that's the one I got from you when you came into the office, right?
Yeah.
I wanted that the pop of that cream cheese, and man, it was delicious.
Sorry, what are you looking at, man?
Oh, I'm.
What you were looking at something?
Nah, I'm listening to your story taking
that was
it all in, all the smells and the looks and the tastes.
I'm gonna do what he's doing, so I don't keep getting on my hands.
You just said a while ago you are referred to as the Martha Stewart of Asheville High School.
That's what I was in the gym working on the sets for. You know, the Bulldog Bowtie Theater Company. And I'm sitting there painting. Shay Monroe looks over at me. Are you just like the Martha Stewart of Asheville High School all of a sudden?
You should have looked at him and said, happy little tree. And just started.
I was like, what are you talking about? Because, you know, I was in the zone. He goes, you paint, you bake. He's like, you haven't been to prison yet, but I'm just like, I don't really plan on the third one.
It's coming.
But if it does happen, then I guess I am the Martha Stewart of Asheville High School. Just introduce me to Snoop Dogg.
I was about to say, just find you a West Coast rapper that you
oddly
befriend. And
well, Snoop Dogg has a house down in Florida, and it was where my mom used to live. She's moved since then. It was only a few miles down the road.
So technically, you know Snoop Dogg.
Basically, yeah.
Yeah.
Just like how I know Luke Bryan and, you know.
There you go. So at the behest of basically repeating our former episode, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hi, I'm Morgan Gray. I'm 26 years old.
Just to clarify, I work with Morgan. David works with Morgan. You don't.
I do not. I don't work
with
Well,
indirectly.
I don't work any of y'all, technically.
Well, technically, you and I work together.
But here's the thing. Like, I've noticed that there are a ton of teachers and coaches that, like, know me now.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we went to the Sports Foundation meeting the other day. And, well, look, don't try to swallow and talk at the same time. It's just not a good combination.
It's only 7 a.m.
Yeah. Anyway, the volleyball coach, Mr. Coach Sullivan, she's like, hey, Clint, what's going on? I'm like,
She was at that game you rolled around on the floor.
But still.
with the luchador mask on.
But still. That was not me. That is allegedly me. No one knows identity of that mask, that very, very good looking. He doesn't know. He doesn't know. So, anywho, I'm starting to realize that, hey, like, I'm starting to be known, and I don't know if I like that or not. I can't get away with near as much as people start knowing.
You're not
going
to be able to get away with all the rolling on the floor and that halftime.
Well, look,
I mean, you will. They'll just know it's you.
In 25 years, nobody stopped me yet, so.
Excuse me, sir. Can you stop rolling around on the floor with a luchador mask?
What?
What'd she say?
She said it's almost my whole life.
26, right?
Yeah.
26.
She literally just said that.
Do you know Luke Bryan?
No, I do not know Luke Bryan.
You've had him over here thinking
he
that.
He also just lived a couple of miles from my mom when she lived on 30A.
Okay.
Wait. Your mom lived in 30A?
Yeah,
on 30A?
We lived in Seagrove for about 5 years.
What? Hey, this is new information. Let's
I worked in Seaside for a while.
I don't know what that is.
It's like the bougiest part of the Emerald Coast.
Yeah.
The bougiest.
Except Seagrove was considered the ghetto. But
beforehand?
It's still, you know, Luke Bryan had a house in Seagrove and it was sold or selling now for, you know, several million dollars.
Yeah. So what does your mom do?
She's a nurse. She Down works there. At a surgery center right now in Crestview.
And she comes up and visits you, right? She'll come.
Yeah, occasionally. Yeah. She likes to pop up and get a little, somehow get a little break from the beach, but, you know, get old Pale City.
Well, so did you grow up? You didn't grow up down there.
No, I grew up in Prattville.
Yeah, so you grew up in Prattville, and then did y'all go your separate ways once you left the house? Or?
They moved in, I don't remember the year. It was my junior year of college. They ended up moving to Florida. Mm-hmm. And so I went down, helped them move, and they were down there, and my mom and brother stayed down there for a while. My dad's back in back in the Prattville area, mm-hmm. and he lives in Holtville now, so close enough.
The Holtville Bulldogs.
Yeah.
And now my brother. They are basically the actual doppelganger. I'm not even kidding.
They're like, green. They're green and white.
They're green and white. They're Bulldogs. Their last name stops with Ville.
That's like every other town in Alabama.
That's true. But their fight song's the exact same. Their marching band costumes in 2001 were exactly the same. It's crazy how, like, literally doppelganger they are to us.
Interesting.
There's also they ran a single wing last year a little bit, too.
They did.
Yeah.
There's also the Brantley Bulldogs that are also green and white.
Really?
Anyway.
You also got the Leeds Green Wave also.
Which we used to be the Green Wave.
We used to be the Green Wave, and Leeds is green and white.
Yeah.
I wonder why we changed to Bulldogs.
Because they were Green Wave. I think that's
who was
why.
Green? They were Green Wave first? I don't know. I assume.
I think our yearbook was the Green Wave, and we just sort of took it up as our moniker, and then we had a vote, and we changed our name and let Leeds have it.
What Prattville? You went to Prattville?
Yes.
And then did you go to Montevallo?
Yes.
Right. Oh, now Seagrove. Is it Seagrove?
Mm-hmm.
What'd you do down there?
Well, I worked in Seaside. We lived in Seagrove. I worked at a bakery down there.
Oh, it makes sense. It makes sense.
Is that where it all started?
No.
There with the baking?
No. I enjoyed my job. I didn't enjoy the company I worked for. I was their sales manager, and every time the owners would come by, I'd have to reintroduce myself. Mm. So it was a great time. But no, baking started when I was younger. Me and my mom used to bake a lot growing up.
You so. should have took that opportunity to change your name.
Yeah, you should have changed it every time.
It should have been Morgan, Megan, Mallory.
Every M name.
I would have done like, he's got a cool story I think he's told on the podcast before. I would have done what he did. I'd have been like, yes, my name is hold on, let's see. Who can I? Who would they know? I would have just said, yes, I'm Julia Roberts.
Morgan Wallen.
Nice to meet you. Hey, I'm Morgan Wallen.
I'm Morgan
Luke
Freeman.
Bryan. Well, what's his name? Malzahn never learns your name. You were just always, hey, camera guy.
Well, no, I went from hey, camera guy to hey, you. Hey, Jamie's guy. Because Jamie was the DFO. So,
well, at least he kind of knew what you did.
Yeah, he knew. He at least knew that I went from video to operations.
Yeah.
He at least knew that much. Well, I said, he said my name one time.
Okay.
He got it right one time.
I don't think they ever said my name.
Well, that's terrible.
Yeah.
Well, so that's why I try to go around saying everybody's first name every now and see if I can get everybody's name around the school. Because everybody just refers to everybody's
not
coach,
me.
Coach,
I don't know why.
Mister.
Everybody calls me by my in front of the kids. I'm the only, and it doesn't piss me off, but it's kind of like, in front of the kids, could you at least just say coach?
Do I do that? Am I bad about that too? Or do I say
no.
Mr. Wilson?
No, you don't say my name.
You just
ever.
Stare at him, probably.
What, hey there, how you what doing? Do you want me to call you?
Hey there, how you
well,
doing?
Mr. Wilson. My kids coach call me Coach Wilson.
Okay, I'll call you Coach Wilson.
I call you Coach Murphree.
Yeah. You want me to just say, hey, teacher guy?
That would yes, please say that. Hey, teacher,
hey, teacher guy.
Hey, teacher guy with glasses.
That'll make you feel like normal, I guess. Yeah. From in your,
but like, see, like
you
Tom
feel
Lamb.
Like Emmett from
hey, art,
Lego.
Art woman. That's
Lego
what you
movie.
Get called at the other school, right? Hey, art person.
Okay, I can't give them so much hate today because, so yesterday, I was on my way to Raglan, And I was bebopping over there up the mountain, and then my tire pressure light comes on. I had 18 in my back driver's side tire, and I was like, oh my God. So I was like, well, let's just get to the school. Let's just see how far we can push this.
Yeah.
And I'm driving 16, 14, 12. Oh, we're at 10 now. And so I turn to the parking lot. I get to
10,
my parking spot.
9,
I get 8. Out, and it is just pouring. And I look at it, and it's sure enough, my tire is flat as this piece of paper. And so I go and I start looking around. Chunk of metal in it about this big. So I'm like, well, let's just see if I can blow it up. Let's just try this little experiment.
That didn't work.
I just got a straw and no, I got my little air compressor, I hooked it up, I start blowing, I just hear
It's just going straight through.
And I'm like, okay, nope. So the ag teacher changed my tire to my donut. Yeah. And so I'm driving around on donut because they didn't have my tire in stock and they can't repair it. And it's $200. And I just got new tires in January. So now I'm spending $1,000 on tires.
Wait a minute. So you just got one. Okay. But all right. I guess a piece of metal in there wouldn't kind of warranty or nothing.
I don't
nothing.
Know. If you bought the warranty, it'll usually cover it, like the roadside thing. Or
they didn't offer it to me. Yeah.
So it's always the ag guy, isn't it? Fixes everything. Every single thing. To get a rat out of the heater and everything.
But I did. Yep. I sat there for an hour yesterday like, who at this school would actually help me change a tire? Because I know here I could go to any classroom and I'll be like, oh, yeah, come on, let's go do it. And there I was like, oh, my God. The guy across the hall, he's not going to help me. He's going to laugh at me. The coach doesn't even talk to me. And so I was like, you know what? I bet Buckner, he'll help me change my tire. And I go and ask him. He's like, are you sure it needs to be changed and not just blown up? And I'm like, no, it's going...
Huh? Is that Pike's brother?
Yeah.
So
I love Pike. Pike will never listen to this, but I love Pike. Before we get too far, you got to remember this is technically the first time everybody's met you, so you have to explain the context.
Oh yeah, I work at two schools. Yes. I work here in the morning, and the middle school, and then I'm at Raglan in the afternoon for context.
And you teach art.
Yes, and I teach art based on Art Woman.
But are you still Art Woman there, or do you have a name?
Honestly, I don't really know.
You kind of.
Yeah, I just kind of show up and do my thing. So the kids know who I am, and I think they know who I am. They may not know my name, though.
They know to let you in the building.
Yes, yeah. They know when I scan in and they see my little face on the camera, because my fob's set up for both schools, that I'm not an intruder. I do have a classroom. They just may not know my name.
Wow. That's who you texting over there?
My wife. She just told me she got to work. I told her to be sure to tell me when she got here.
Because
the weather's going to be bad in there.
Hey, your phone is picking up everything you're saying.
It did that yesterday, and I don't know why.
You might have hit your little microphone.
Okay, it's doing it now.
You know, I got a buddy of mine.
She told me she got to work. I told her. Okay, that's what I said.
Yeah.
I got a buddy of mine that just switched his phone over, and it was doing the same thing yesterday. I had to do what you just did.
Yeah, well, our assistant principal just got an iPhone. Huff got an iPhone.
Oh, did he?
And
he's a blue text.
So no joke. I had to send him a text the other day in class about a kid that asked to go to the bathroom, and I told him no, and he just got up and walked out anyway. And so I'm like, hey, so-and-so just got up and walked out. I'm going to write him up and send you a write-up slip and just send him to the office. And I sent the text, and it was blue, and I'm like, and then I sent him an immediate, I just went, oh, you got an iPhone. Congrats.
All right, so you're driving around on the donut.
I'm driving around on the donut for now. I'm hoping my tire's going to be in this afternoon.
This afternoon. All right.
So, you know, no offense, but I'm going to delve into... Ooh. I want to delve into the stereotypes of art teacher.
Let's do it.
And how you defeat some of those stereotypes. First stereotype. Well,
first of all, her hair's not a different color, so there's that.
Well, yeah. Well, I mean, it could have been at some point. You don't know that.
I've never dyed my hair.
Have you ever thought about it?
I've thought about it. I've never done it. My stepmom.
Please don't, because
it's
gonna make me look silly. Because I just said that.
Oh.
I've thought about dyeing my hair.
What color?
Gray.
Okay.
Yeah, me too.
Mine's already naturally going there.
Dang, really?
Yeah.
I don't know if mine is.
The grays gray early.
It's really.
Yeah.
Well, so do the Thompsons.
Mine's not. Yeah, not quite there. You can't quite tell yet.
Thompson, when'd you start, Clint?
Hey, Thompson.
Hey, Thompson. Clint, when'd you start going gray?
So define. First started going, like when I first started seeing gray hair, like 12.
Okay, when did it all go?
Like this 13. It was in the last like this has been in like the last 10 years, but like it's been very salt and pepper before that. Like it was a good bit gray when I was in college, 19.
Well, does anybody 19, ever 18. Mistake you for being much older than you are because of your hair?
Yes.
Or like your face?
Yes, my face. It's a glandular problem.
Hey, he loves saying glandular. For I some do. Reason.
It's a funny. It's a funny word.
So you to dictate you that I'm overweight have been. You basically have been gray since you were 20. Since you were my age,
yeah.
Her age,
yeah.
Her age,
yeah.
26, 27. Yeah. Okay. My next question.
Distinguishing.
My next question was going to be something that we've never talked about on this podcast, which was. Your taste in music is very diverse, but one thing, one genre that you do enjoy, which is odd in my opinion,
reggae,
an art teacher, yeah. And that's country music.
I love country
You're
music.
You're a massive Alan Jackson fan.
I am,
correct?
Yes.
So, why?
Well,
not like you've told this story before.
Never told this one. When I grew up.
Because she likes the Chattahoochee.
All right, y'all have a great day. I'm going to go.
Sorry.
David didn't know.
Your face is my case. Way down yonder on the Chattahoochee.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
Growing up, I would ride around with my dad a lot in his pickup truck and stuff, and he had a 16-song CD, and it was just a burnt CD with 16 of his favorite songs. And Midnight Montgomery was one of them, so that was like my first taste of Alan Jackson. So we got the sad taste to begin with. And I loved it, and he was one of those I grew up listening to, so... Mm-hmm.
Midnight in Montgomery.
Yeah.
Me and a bunch of buddies of mine tried to find that cemetery in Montgomery one night. I was going to go out there. We never could find it. We
drove ride. From here to Montgomery?
No, I don't remember why we were down there.
Okay.
We were already there coming through or something. We tried to find it. We couldn't find it. When that song was real popular.
Oh. That was before my time.
So that's about going to Hank Williams' grave,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I can't remember where it is. I had a friend that knew where it was, and we were going to go one night, and then it just never happened.
It never manifested.
Yeah. That's okay. It wasn't meant to be.
I enjoy Montgomery.
Not many
people say that, but I do.
That's where my grandmother lived. That's where my mom grew up for the most part.
So, Alan Jackson, which obviously you're interested in more than just Alan Jackson, but like so that era of country music, what I would call 90s prime country.
Yes.
Would that be?
That's what SiriusXM calls it.
It's 80s and 90s prime country.
But he came along. Earlier than that, didn't he come in kind of mid to late 80s?
Yeah. I think so.
Probably.
I feel like his prime, though, was the 90s. When I think Alan Jackson, I think early 90s.
Okay.
Early to mid 90s. Right. As sort of his, not his apex, but as sort of where he first reached, you know, like country music legend status.
Now, how did he get famous, though? Didn't his wife?
I think it was singing.
Oh, absolutely.
No, sorry.
Didn't his wife get somebody to listen to somebody that was already famous?
It in the airport or something?
Yeah. Who did she go up to
you
give him
me that story? Did you?
No, I didn't tell you that. But that's how she begged the person to play his music or something, listen to his tape. But I don't know who that was though.
Because wasn't he originally like a singer songwriter, or a songwriter specifically, and. Nobody would sing his songs, and then he's like, well, screw it, I'll just start singing them.
He's from Georgia. Alan Jackson's from Georgia.
His daughter went to Auburn.
Oh, gosh, here we go again.
There he is.
I always got to throw that in there for my Alabama fans.
Yeah, we need to figure out who that was.
We'll Google it later. We'll figure it out for
you. Well, I was going to say, I mean, it's not like we don't have these things called smartphones literally attached to our hands, and we couldn't figure this out real quick.
Well, what other artists are you engaged in?
Picasso.
Sorry.
I actually don't like him. He's kind of a piece of work.
He was a piece of work.
Yeah.
Like just country or like outside of country?
Like in terms, what's the scope of country interest for you?
Well, you've got our Alan. You've got Trace, George.
Always George.
Which George?
George Strait is the king.
Right. It's my favorite. Sorry. It's okay. If it's
Trace.
Adkins.
Okay.
I love me some Trace.
Yeah, I grew up with, my dad was basically Trace Adkins' twin. Growing up, it was hilarious to me.
that is funny.
Long hair and everything. And then, as I got older, got really into, I don't want to say it was bro country, because, at the time, it wasn't yet, because, Country Girl wasn't out by Luke Bryan. But I got really into, Luke Bryan and so on. And I'm super into, John Langston, Muscadine Bloodline.
I've recently gotten into Muscadine Bloodline.
Oh my god, they are so good.
They came to Gadsden a year ago,
something like that. Yeah,
like last June or something like that. And I had an opportunity to go, but I didn't know who they were. So I'm like, I'm good.
No, they are so freaking good. I love those guys.
Yeah, they're it's a really cool. They're unique.
Yeah,
like nobody else sounds like them. Wait, what?
I'm on first name basis with them.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
No, really?
Like, me and John Langston are, too. Yeah.
Are they going to, like, look at you and call you Melissa because they don't remember your name?
No, they'll call me Morgan.
Okay.
Like, that's serious.
How? Cool. Tell us that story.
I've seen them about 10 times live.
Wow.
So.
Okay.
So just, and it's all been pretty local. I've gone to several of their shows and just gotten to meet and talk, and it's, you know, first name basis now.
So you're a, basically, you're sort of like David. You're a big live music.
Oh my God, yes.
Fan.
Yes.
You like live music.
Yeah,
right?
I love live music. I'll go listen to anything. I mean, I just went and watched the Glenn Miller Orchestra the other night, so I'll go listen to anything.
You didn't tell me about that.
Yeah.
How was that?
It was good.
It was good.
It was good. I mean, I enjoyed it, but I mean, it's just, it's not my thing, but it was live music and I enjoyed it. Yeah. I mean, you know, you've heard that music all your life, yeah, but you may not have known who it was.
Sure.
Like in movies and right, stuff, you hear that Glenn Miller music. So a lot of the stuff
that
they played,
that was what
before
you got your mom for Christmas, right?
Yeah. We went to that, went to the Bright Star restaurant, nice, the oldest restaurant in Alabama, yeah, and then went to that. But it was good. But it was on Friday. You know, I'd worked all week and I was just kind of tired. The music was great, but they just play a lot of stuff, you know, that almost puts you to sleep.
Yeah.
Too, you know.
Did you get your laundry done after that? Or
yeah, no, I had to go home and do my laundry, so I had to stay up like 4 a.m. get all that done.
You do laundry on Friday nights?
Yeah, Friday nights.
Interesting.
Yeah, but Glenn Miller, it was good. I mean, I'd go back again because I mean, I love live music.
Quick question. I can't believe this has never been a topic. Who is a live band you've seen before they actually hit it big? So, like, you're talking about Muscadine Bloodline. Is that, yeah, is that what it's called?
Real big, huh?
Like, they might be on the cusp of making it pretty, mm-hmm, like bigger than what they are. So, you know, if they're playing Gadsden now in maybe 3 or 4 years, they might be playing like several different places. So
mine would have to be a little Big Town because I'm kind of like her.
I
was right there like before they really hit it big.
On the ground floor.
Yeah, like going and seeing them at Zydeco's, mm-hmm, Barking Kudu, mm-hmm, in Birmingham.
I love that name.
Those play. Well, see, I went to that CD release party that night when they just, they weren't a whole lot of people there.
And you, yeah, told us, you've told that story on here, right? Before that.
Well, I mean, I went to that, and I talked to them, too. I mean, we're not on a first-name basis,
okay,
but that, it, they would
so
just
cool
be out there where you just walk up and talk, yeah, to them. So I just walked up and talked to them at Zydeco and Barking Kudu and everything, because they'd just be out there. They're, I mean, they're pretty big now. I mean, they're better than Fleetwood Mac.
They're not, but...
I mean, they do Fleetwood, yeah, Mac better than Fleetwood Mac.
They don't.
Are they a big band now? Are they?
Who, Fleetwood Mac?
No, Little Big
Fleetwood
Town.
Fleetwood Mac's massive.
Is Little Big Town, are they a big band?
Little Big Town is Big Town.
Yeah.
Are they? Okay.
They're a big city. They're a little big city.
I don't say.
Little Big Planet.
They've expanded.
Little Big Planet, yeah. I would say they're pretty big.
I'd say you'd say a little
are they
big
enough to
people
headline?
Know a couple of songs.
Yeah.
Are they still like with somebody? That's kind of where, to me, that line is. Are you big enough to headline, or are you big enough to be with
somebody? I think they've headlined before.
Yeah, I've gone to see them headlining. They're on tour also.
I've only been to one concert in my life. That I would consider a concert, and it was a Fall Out Boy concert. I was just like,
I just lost so much respect for you.
Well, it's not that I wanted to go. It's that I was told I had to go.
So they clubbed you and drug you.
That's
what I thought. I rest
basically.
My case.
It was Paramore and Fall Out Boy.
Oh, but Paramore,
I like
so
Paramore.
Good.
Yeah, Paramore opened.
I can't talk about that on here.
You can't?
Well, no, I can't. I'll tell you later. Remind me of that. Write that down somewhere. Paramore.
Paramore, Triple Threat.
No, not Triple Threat. It's not Triple Threat worthy. It's just amongst friends.
It's that bad?
No, it's not that bad. It's just not good.
Oh, because of your glandular problem?
Yes.
Probably.
Okay.
But I was real disappointed at that Glenn Miller thing because he wasn't there.
But his band, his orchestra.
Yeah, his orchestra was, but he wasn't there.
So it's the orchestra just randomly playing because Glenn Miller's not doing this.
Do you know what happened to him?
No.
But he died in a plane crash in World War II.
Well, no wonder he wasn't there.
So you just made a joke at the expense of a dead man.
Well, it was 1944, 45.
Say, it's been a while.
Well, he went ahead of his band over to England. He was flying from France to England over the English Channel, and it was just like him and the pilot. I think he was going ahead of the band because he was still a band leader during World War II. Like an army band, but in the plane crash, and they never found him. So,
John Denver.
I was gonna say John Denver and Ronnie Van Zant, but
yeah. Ronnie. Yeah. What if you're a musician? Don't fly in a plane. That's the moral of the story.
And well, Lynyrd Skynyrd.
There's another
run out
joke
of fuel
there, and I can't make it.
But the plane, before they took off, I was reading about it, and evidently the plane wasn't in the best of shape, and he told the pilot, "You really think we need to do this on this plane?" Is it? Yeah. Well, you gotta die sometime or something like that.
Oh,
so,
hey,
and
wow.
They did. So they went ahead.
They did die.
Yeah, evidently.
That
sometime was that day.
I wasn't necessarily on the ground floor, but I always thought it was a very cool story how I believe it was Matchbox 20, I think, got their start. Like, not so much got their start in Birmingham, but, you know, they had the X, 1077 the X back in the day, and it was like it played a lot of that new up-and-coming
stuff. Well, Sister
stuff.
Hazel, too. They were right there with them in Birmingham.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. Like, I don't think people really realize that they're in that early 2000s, how kind of the – you know how Seattle gets the grunge bands? Mm-hmm. Birmingham was kind of big because we had several bands in the area. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, 1077 The X was really big regionally. And, you know, they kind of had the upstart for a bunch of bands.
Yeah, I wasn't really into that much. But, that was pretty big at that time. You know Sister Hazel?
I've heard of them.
Yeah, they're pretty good. I got to where I kind of liked that, Sister Hazel music and Hootie and Blowfish, stuff like that.
Blues Traveler. I like Blues Traveler pretty well.
I'm not a big live music guy.
I'm not either. Like, I get drugged to them. Yeah, I get drugged to them, but, you know, I think it's more dealing with the people that I don't like.
See, I think that's it, too. It's like, because there's always
everybody's
got
to have
rough,
an excuse to
rowdy.
Go and do stuff they wouldn't do.
Yeah. Like, I really want to go see Jason Isbell with him and Mark and Heather and his wife.
Well, you need to, if you're going to go, you just need to get tickets.
But are you
got to get tickets.
No way! I didn't know that's how that works.
June jam, or you might be able, to just get in.
Hold on, aren't you going to the June jam with him?
Yeah, I already got my June jam ticket.
Tickets.
Ticket. I already got my June jam tickets, and I got my Jason Isbell tickets. It's all in June. June's
Do you know
big
how
month.
Much I for two tickets to the June jam? You know how much it is with fees and everything?
$700.
$198.
I was a little off.
A lot better
how
than
much did
South.
You think? How much did you think it was going to be?
$5.
Oh, you got to be kidding me! No, I mean, a concert ticket. You go see the Eagles today. You're going to pay $300 a ticket.
No, I'd pay $300 to see the Eagles.
What you want? Mm.
No, I mean,
shots fired, David. How do you feel
about what?
That he wouldn't pay $300 a ticket to go see Alabama.
No, that's not what I said. Because we don't know. Okay, we'll never see Alabama. I'll never see Alabama play in my life.
And that's sad. That is so sad. You could have gone to see them. I mean, you're old enough, you could have gone to see them.
But when was the last time they performed?
Alabama together. Probably all together when Jeff Cook could still play. And I had tickets to this concert this night, but I didn't go because the weather was real bad. The tornado relief concert they had over at Jacksonville State.
Yeah.
think that would be about the last time he would.
But see, they only played two or three songs that night, I think. Because then they had Riley Green.
Jason Isbell was there that night,
love
too.
Riley Green.
Well, Riley Green's local. I actually worked with Riley's uncle.
Yeah, I've seen him a couple of times.
That was a good lineup that night.
I know.
Oh, okay.
I don't know Riley Green like that. Sorry.
But, I mean, I was prepared to pay. I was expecting it to be $100. And sure. I would have paid. I was ready the other day to go to $150.
Okay.
And then I would have had to think about it a little more after that. I may have gone up $200. I don't know.
What are things that y'all do that with?
No, I take that back. I have seen Confederate Railroad live. Sorry, go ahead. I forgot about that experience.
Where was that?
Greensport. Yep.
Was it good?
It was, actually. They did it.
They are
so
good.
We talked about
really
ground level. We talked about ground level, and then we talked about peak. Now we're talking about basement.
No. Confederate, no.
Not them. I'm just saying they're on the way back side of their career.
But,
like,
you know, Confederate Railroad, their drummer lives in Margaret.
Yeah.
So he's local, and they did a really, really, really good job. And they had some bands and some people open for them that have since gotten more famous but aren't famous.
I went to see them one night. It was, I think, Chris LeDoux opened up. Then it was Tracy Byrd, then Confederate Railroad, then John Anderson.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just crazy when Confederate Railroad was out there at Oak Mountain. But then after they got finished, like half the crowd left before the headliner came out, John Anderson. So everybody was pretty much there just to see Confederate Railroad.
Nobody wanted to hear Seminole win.
But Chris LeDoux, he was there. Oh, no, that's a good song.
It is a good song.
John Anderson is good. He can still perform.
I like John Anderson.
I wanted to see him real bad.
Swinging.
But, Chris LeDoux, he got tied up in his microphone or his guitar cord and fell down on stage that night. LeDoux. All right, Prattville.
All right.
Montevallo.
Yes.
What was your degree? What did you get your degree in?
I got my bachelor's in fine art and my master's in art education.
Okay.
Graphic design. Originally,
and then I stopped and did printmaking.
Yes, because your graphic design professor was terrible.
Yes, and I had a C for the semester because I missed a critique because I was in the hospital for an allergic reaction and couldn't make it, and she wouldn't just exempt me from it because I was dying.
Wait a minute, back up a little bit.
It wasn't cinnamon rolls, was it?
No, it was tree nuts.
Yeah. So see, that's what she told me when you asked her to make banana nut bread. She said, I can't, I'm allergic.
Because of tree nuts.
Yeah.
Okay. Pecans.
Yes. Peanuts. Macadamia nuts, cashews. Well,
hold on.
Almonds.
Peanuts aren't a
exactly. That's
peanut.
What I, that's
peanuts
what I want to
clarify. Peanuts are a legume.
Yeah, so that you're not true. Allergic to peanuts.
No, I can eat peanuts.
Okay. But anything that comes from a tree.
Yes.
What about a vine? I don't know any nuts come from.
Okay.
Are you still real? So you're still real allergic to that?
Yeah,
now?
I have to carry an EpiPen.
Oh, it's that kind of bad.
So, like, okay. I tell my students at the beginning of the year, "Hey, this is my allergy. If y'all bring something in and I start having a reaction, just stab me with this in my thigh for 10 seconds, and then get an administrator because I have to go to the hospital."
I'm not telling any student to stab me.
Well, there are some that I think would get a lot of just like
joy.
It would be really cathartic for them. So
some of them really enjoy it. I know
okay.
Some of mine would really enjoy it.
I don't know if they really enjoy it with me. I like to think I'm pretty chill. I don't think there's that many kids that hate me. But I think some of them would like, it would be really, like, it would probably be a good release
yeah.
for
them. Yeah.
Yeah. No, that, yeah, you get it to the heart, right? Yeah.
No,
if you're paying to the heart.
Nope, right to the thigh.
Straight up Pulp Fiction.
Right to the thigh, please.
All right, so.
Does the nurse know about this?
Actually, I don't know.
You should probably make that conversation.
I can stop myself with it. Like, I've
done
it before.
No, no, no. I'm not saying for, like, liability. I'm just saying just so that, like, if, you know, something goes down and a kid doesn't do it and
true.
You're in there on the floor, you know, and
I mean,
then.
It does make me feel better. I have had to do it to myself.
Well, here's the thing.
Wow.
Like, I'm
wow.
next door to you.
Yes.
So if,
I'll just
like,
start hitting
the next
wall really
closest
hard.
Adult is me.
Yes.
So.
And McCarthy.
Well, and McCarthy.
And Clayton. And Rhonda.
And yeah, well, yeah.
Well, look.
You're good there.
We've documented this on this show that I choked on a little small piece of hamburger meat while eating spaghetti.
He almost
time.
Died.
I did almost die. So I'm saying that to say, like, if your airway closes up and you can't breathe, all of a sudden you pass out, like, there's no hitting the wall.
It takes a few, like, a minute or two for things to start closing up for me. I know
that's
immediately
what I thought,
when
too.
Happens.
Where's the pen? Do they know where the pen is?
Yeah, it stays in my little bag.
Okay. Have you ever been... Have you ever had to use one before on yourself?
She just said she did.
When?
Just
like
right,
literally
ago.
3 seconds
oh, really?
Ago.
I think I zoned out.
What year? How long ago was it that you had to do
I
it?
Was a junior.
Yesterday.
So it was like 6 years ago? 5 years ago? I don't remember if it was 17.
Oh, that was the context as to why you were in the hospital, which is why you're graphic
yes.
design. Okay, gotcha. Okay.
Yeah, I was at like an art gallery
He doesn't
show.
Listen to me either.
That's okay.
Or what? Me. What'd you say?
I was at an art gallery opening at the school. And they had white chocolate macadamia nut cookies, and I loved these. Like, I'd had them before, never had a problem. I've only ever had an issue with cashews, so I ate one. I only ate, like, half of one, and then my finger started to feel real swollen. I was like, what the heck is going
crap.
On, man? And so I start walking back to my apartment, just like, we're just going to get home. And then I can't breathe. I'm like, oh, my God, are you kidding me? So I get home in the leg. I ended up actually driving to CVS in the middle of this reaction, too, and got some Benadryl for myself, popped it, then got back home, woke up one of my roommates and said, hey, I need you to drive me to the ER. And she did.
Well, they probably just thought at the art thing when you, I mean, if you'd passed out or something, you were just amazed at the great
probably.
Art. Probably. Now, when did you realize you had this?
I was in, like, elementary school. Elementary, we were eating, okay. We were on our way back. I think it was from church, actually. And my mom was eating some cashews, and I was like, hey, I want to try one of those. And so I popped one in. I liked it, so I popped, like, two more in, and then I became violently ill. And my mom's
wow.
a nurse, so we just kind of wrote it out at home.
Wow. I got a guy that I work with. He is allergic to cashews is a very weird thing to say when it comes to this, because he said that the oils in cashews are a lot like the oils and stuff that are in poison ivy. It's between oak and ivy, so oivy.
Okay.
Yeah. Anyway, he can't eat cashews because, like,
he's that allergic to poison oak,
so.
Poison ivy.
I guess
interesting.
So. Interesting. But like, you know, I'll get the rash or whatnot
yeah.
if I ever go up against it. But I eat cashews all the time. It really is a glandular problem.
I, you know, there's a, I was reading an article, I don't know, it was a couple months ago about, like, why there are so many more people now, especially young people that are allergic to, like, peanuts and tree
yeah.
nuts and stuff like that.
That is odd.
And it's, like, compared to other developed countries, like, apparently it's a phenomenon going on in the United States, and scientists and biologists and doctors are like, what's going on? Apparently... according to this researcher, he works at Harvard or the Mayo Clinic, somewhere like that. And he's like, his working theory is that because we don't expose our children to diverse things in our diet, in the American diet, There's not like natural organic things. It's very processed when they're young.
Chicken fingers and mac and cheese.
And it's like, hey, don't give them peanuts. Don't give them milk. Don't whatever, yeah. You know. They develop. That's why we have so many people that are lactose intolerant now. That's why we have, or they develop these intolerances because they might be exposed to them as children, but then their diet changes and they only want to eat chicken fingers between the ages of 4 and 10. So I thought that was kind of interesting.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that just makes sense. I mean, we could have figured that out because there's not as much agriculture in the area. You just don't come and cut. Well, I made my wife eat peanuts when she was pregnant.
Yeah, I made that's her smart. Eat them. That's smart because that way your girl.
I just
kind of
let them all.
You're so smart.
Did you sit her down and go, "You have to eat"?
Yeah, you got to eat this.
Why didn't you do it with tree nuts? Now you've left them open.
But I mean, I don't know that we didn't. I mean, she was probably eating, like you said, you ate. What'd you eat at the art show?
Oh, a white chocolate macadamia nut cookie.
Well, she probably was eating stuff with that in there too, like those type nuts.
My mom probably was too, and look at me now.
Yeah.
But you made the conscious decision
to
sit
her
Julie,
down and you're eating peanuts.
I'm gonna watch you eat these peanuts.
Because you hear about peanut allergies more than anything.
You really do.
Probably. So yeah. I
haven't heard about that as much lately though. Like I'm not saying there's not kids out there, but like it was almost like an epidemic at one point.
Well in the '80s I heard nothing about it at all.
Right. Right,
90s, maybe
not
late
really,
90s
but like in the late 90s, it seemed like it started becoming a thing. Yeah, like, hey, you can't bring a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Oh, yes,
yeah,
a huge thing now. Yeah.
Now everybody
loves the Uncrustables.
Well, now it's sort of like it's almost like everything else. It's almost being flipped on its head. It's like, no, we don't need to, because the more you limit their exposure, the more allergies that are going to be developed. So we need to expose them. Da 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 da. So now it's sort of like slowly the attitude is slowly changing, where it's like, you can't shield them from everything because it's just going to exacerbate the problem.
Hey, how are they allowed to have those
Uncrustables?
Yeah, how are we allowed to have these?
Don't we have like
on
a peanut-free table?
Yeah, yeah, and I think we have a peanut-free food production line and a one that.
Okay, because for a while there, you just couldn't have any.
Anything.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I think we've sort of like split the kitchen where this half the kitchen's peanut, this half the kitchen's not peanut.
These kids that can't have peanuts have to sit at this table.
Yeah.
These kids that can sit at this table. It's crazy.
I really
man.
Don't think we have any. I don't ever see any of the kids sit
at
the
nut-free
tables.
I know
tables.
I have one at Raglan that has a peanut allergy. That's the only kid I know about.
I'm so glad. I'm sure everybody listening is just fascinated.
I know,
by
right? About our peanut and tree nut conversation. Wow.
I know.
At 7:41 a.m. Good morning, Asheville, Alabama.
Good morning, Vietnam.
Wait now. Don't do it.
What?
Don't do it. It's a sensitive subject.
Hey, Praxis. Did you take the Praxis?
God, I took the Praxis, yes.
You just took it?
No, I took it in college. It took me 3 tries to pass the art one.
So you got your degree in art or in design and everything, but then you had to take the Praxis to be able to be in a teach.
And like the art Praxis, they would literally be like, here's the name of some random artist. What kind of artist are they? It's like, I don't know.
Picasso.
And then there was like one, there was a lot of questions on jewelry making. I'm like,
what?
I don't know. And so I took it twice the summer before the semester I needed it. I was under it by one point what I needed. So I had to take a semester off and I took it 2 weeks after the semester started and got 10 points above.
There you go.
What type of art is Picasso? What is that?
He painted.
What era was that?
Who would have been the early...
It's
early 1900s
stuff, right?
Early to mid 1900s, yeah.
Like Guernica, he did
Guernica
the
in the Spanish Civil War, yeah.
He had some cool pieces, but Guernica's as a person, cool. Not good.
Terrible. So Guernica, that would be all that cubism and all that, the angles and all that time period.
Yeah. Right there.
Well, what's your favorite piece of art?
My favorite piece of art?
Yeah.
I mean, if we're going like all time, anything by Van Gogh. The first time I saw his art in a museum, it brought me to tears. It's gorgeous up in person. Like, even just looking at a picture of it or a replication of it. Like, you know, you've got the big Starry Night mural in my classroom here. All the random paintings of it throughout the school on the ceiling tiles.
Just knocked.
They sure did.
So you probably like that classroom really good.
Oh, I do. When I first walked in, you know, last school year, my first day when Miss J showed me my room, I was like, man, I think this room was meant for me. So I was real excited about it.
So Van Gogh, was that your favorite?
I think he's definitely one of my favorite, like, if we're going just, like, all time, just because of the texture that he has in his art, the subject matter. I love it. The colors.
Shay wanted me to tell Martha Stewart of Asheville hello.
Hello, Shay. Do you want a cinnamon roll?
Oh, that, buddy, does he.
He can really call me Martha Stewart.
So, no, it's an inside joke. So he always thinks that I'm making fun of how much weight he's gained, because he's very what, me making fun of his weight or him being sensitive about
everything. Oh, never mind. What's the conversation for another time?
To pick back, and it's funny because you mentioned something about Nick's hair.
What?
Wait, what?
My hair?
Yeah. Wait, did I say something about his hair?
We just got to talk about everybody's hair gray. While I go, except for mine.
Yeah.
I was talking about my hair turning gray.
Oh. Didn't we have something about
your hair? What about his hair?
No.
Oh, you said you wanted, coloring hair, you wanted yours to be gray. Well, I was going to say you just don't want it to turn loose, because that's the running joke, that your hair is.
I love it. Look at it. That one.
Mm. What was that?
Why you have to? You just do a simple.
Yeah.
She shot you a bird.
Did she not see what he just did?
I just shot him a bird.
All
right. Don't watch this live.
He
don't
just shot the camera
live.
A bird.
Hey, by the way, if because we hadn't said it yet, if you're not watching this, go to YouTube and Spotify. You can watch this. Also, subscribe to Lens Plus on Apple Podcasts or Spotify to get all the bonus episodes, Triple Threats, all that good stuff, and to get episodes a week early on Apple Podcasts. These episodes, these main episodes, you get them a week early before anybody else if you subscribe. $1.99 on Apple Podcasts, 99 cents a month on Spotify. Thank you for supporting the show.
Sponsored by Carvana.
Cinnamon rolls.
Yep.
State Farm.
Van Gogh, that's your favorite. What is that Starry Night? Is that your favorite Van Gogh piece?
Probably.
What's some other ones? I don't know that I know any other.
He's super famous for that one. The sunflower paintings, his self-portrait, and there's one, I can't remember the exact name of it, but it was of a sailor slash postman. Oh, there was a whole movie about it done in oil paintings that was on Amazon Prime at one point. God, I can't remember the name of it for the life of me, but I saw it when I went to Boston, and it was really cool.
Wasn't the sunflower like his last piece of work?
Oh, you're asking me questions I don't know the answer to.
I listened to a podcast. Did you listen to it too? Yeah. There's a short history of Vincent Van Gogh. Yeah. We'll send it to you. It's
much appreciated.
It's really cool. He lived a depressing life.
Yeah, yes, he did.
That
he
Joker. Did. He
That's
made such beautiful stuff.
Painting, like the movie. There was a movie. It was all oil paintings, though, so it wasn't anything filmed, technically. Mm-hmm. Going through his life, but through the point of view of, I think it was the son or grandson of the man that he had painted. So,
wow.
It was cool.
Where else you taught?
This is it.
This is the first job.
Okay. This is only second year teaching.
Okay.
Because I got my master's, so I didn't graduate until 2020.
I'm going to go ahead and mark that question.
Okay. I was wondering, you got a lot of stuff written down.
Yeah, so he walked up to me yesterday, and he said, hey, I went in the studio, and I got some cards. No joke, he had it was like this thick of note cards. Like, I got to take some notes.
He just wants to be prepared.
All right, favorite thing to bake? What's your
favorite thing?
Favorite thing to bake?
I would probably say cookies just because they're easier, but currently I really enjoy making cinnamon rolls because of the whole process for them.
All right, now how long did it take to do this?
Three hours.
Okay. So you started this at 3 this morning? When did you start that?
No, last night, not last this night? Morning. So I went to the tire place last night and cried in their parking lot about not being able to get a tire yesterday, and then cried about Sonic, and then cried about my dentist appointment. And then I went home and was like, let's just go ahead and start. The app wasn't working, so I couldn't get a happy hour drink.
I went to Sonic yesterday. My app worked.
Well, hold on. Well, drinks are always half. Oh, wow.
On the app.
On the app.
And I couldn't order ahead of time.
Did you sign up with your school email?
Yes, I did.
Because you know they got those teacher deals.
Yes, I did.
Wait a minute. Where do they get a teacher deal? It's Sonic.
Yeah, they do they'll send special deals and rewards. I think Chick-fil-A does it too in the Chick-fil-A app.
So I just need to sign up with my school email.
Yeah, it's got to be your school email.
We were actually talking about going to Sonic this morning before I left the house.
Yeah, it's got to be your school.
My kids have never been, I don't think, and they were to get. One of mine was talking about how much I like lemonade, and I told her, well, you need to try a limeade from Sonic. I like those real good.
Ocean water. See if one of them wants to try an ocean water. You don't like ocean water?
Hey, cookies.
Yeah.
What cookie is your favorite one to bake, you said?
Ooh, my favorite one to bake?
Because I like those red velvet.
Did you clock in?
Oh, God, I need to clock in. Okay. I'll clock in. Yeah. It'll be fine. They're used to it. I clocked in at 8:30 one day, so it happens.
It does
favorite cookie to bake? If we're going off like just this like sentimental way of it, probably chocolate chip, because that's what me and mom would bake growing up together. But if we're going like the cinnamon roll cookies I brought for the last episode that no one will ever get to see,
never
to suck. just kidding. Of course, those are lots of fun to make because they're really easy to make, but they're so good.
Yeah, you just can't beat chocolate chip.
She said suck to suck. Recommendations. Do you have any more questions?
What's your favorite podcast, though? What is your favorite podcast? I know you listen to a lot of podcasts. Which one's your favorite one?
Probably currently, just because there's new seasons out, Something Was Wrong is probably my current favorite, just because they're in their new season.
Now, what's that one that you... I listened to some of them, too, but I hadn't listened in a while.
Morbid.
Yeah, Morbid. Something to what?
Something Was Wrong.
Is that like murder stuff, too?
Not really murder. It's stories that people give about people in their life who they should have realized something was wrong before they like started interacting with them in their lives. And some of them are like crazy.
Uh-oh. That's, like, I always worry about crazy. That with other people, yeah. That, with me, that something was wrong. I should have got away from him.
Maybe we worry about that with you.
We talked about you last night.
Oh.
Like something's wrong with him. We just need to get yeah, something
so,
was wrong.
So Nate was telling me that one day you were in class just teaching and then you opened the door and walked out into the hallway, and you just screamed down the hall, "Who goes there?" And then you just came back in class and just started teaching again.
There's people always outside my door. It's just all
me.
The
it's
time.
Just me. I'm sorry.
We were outside of his door not long ago.
Yeah, and he was mad.
He
that
was.
Day.
That was a bad day.
Yeah,
we're
that
sorry.
That was probably the worst day I've had all year. Okay. And I haven't had any bad days
well,
this year,
you
but that was it.
That one.
That yeah. day, it was.
The
it was,
one day that I show up yeah. as a non-school employee.
It was pretty bad that day.
Because Wilson and I, we were actually getting ready to go to a coaching clinic. And I said, hey, let's go walk in on Murphree. He goes, yeah, you want to? And I said, yeah, let's do it. So we go in there, and we knock on the door. And he's like, I ain't got time for this. It's just the door. That he
you know, it's
out.
Probably a good thing y'all showed up because I was fixing to go off. I really. That's probably a good thing y'all showed up.
For context, my kid is in this class,
but it wasn't.
Okay, but I just want you to know you have full parental. Okay. What am I trying to say?
I made him hold up a center block for 15 minutes the other day.
Okay, I was going to ask you about that. Yeah. I went into my room. I was helping Kat with sets, and I come into my room, and Myrna looks at me and she goes, "What are they doing?" I'm like, "What are you talking about?" She says, "Please look outside." So I bend down because my blinds are down by my desk for the projector, and there you are, just standing outside with.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was like, okay. And so I walk by and you're still just out there. And I go back to my room late, like 10 minutes later. You're still out there. I just mm-hmm. never got a chance to ask about it.
You were holding a block over
no,
your head.
No. I was making hit Maze okay. hold a block over his head because I get tired of his, no offense. I get tired of his excuses and poor mental fortitude.
I'm gonna start doing that to the football players in my second period.
Good because then I had to do it again. I had to do it again the same. Well, not
there's
something different to a football player because anyway, yeah.
That spring fever has hit early.
Yeah, it has
really,
say,
really
all
early.
And you got players except for one or seniors.
Really early.
You got to crack down too. Otherwise, yeah. it's by the time
that's
by the time you get to
yeah,
the end
yeah,
of April, clear. it's a free for all. If you
don't
crack down,
yeah, that's true. Let's get off this. Get off there. All right.
Are we gonna do recommendations?
All right. Okay. A podcast called Mine is. Did you find your markers yesterday?
I did not find my mark. I don't
yeah,
know
hey,
where my markers
yeah. What happened?
Two boxes of markers got stolen.
I don't know where they are. I think one may be in the counselor's office from where they were doing that sign a couple weeks ago where all the kids were signing it. I don't know where the second box is.
Huh. Is it pencils or markers? I'll be on the lookout.
Markers.
At. Markers. Okay. All right.
It's a 40 count.
Recommendations.
Okay. It's Body Bags Podcast with Joseph Scott Morgan. Crime Podcast.
I've listened to that one.
Yeah, it's pretty good. He teaches at Jacksonville State. He's supposed to be
does
one,
he really?
One of the best in the country as far as forensics.
He teaches at Jacksonville State.
Of course, Jacksonville State has always had a good criminal justice
they
program.
They have, yeah.
So he teaches there. He's
go ahead.
That's a good podcast.
I'm going to go last because like, mine's long.
Okay, go ahead.
I would like to recommend the song Banana Pancakes by Jack Johnson.
My girl.
Banana Pancakes, Jack
it's
Johnson.
Great, it's yes. a great song. I, like
I don't know
it.
Jack yeah. Johnson.
Murphree asked me about
you
it
don't
yesterday.
Know.
He walked by while it was playing.
How do you not know Jack Johnson? It's, okay.
You've probably overheard it from my classroom
yeah.
at some point.
Who's Jack? Okay.
Upside down. Elaborate? Upside down.
That's my chill mix.
Yeah.
It's kind of more like
that's
indie.
That's a good song.
Kind of
I'm going to listen to that. I'm going to work.
It is a good one.
I'm a...
Bubbly Toes? That's bubbly.
Hold on. What was the, what's sure. the most... What? See... I don't know if it's me rebelling against that genre of music, but I I'm not, I don't know.
So you hate the kind of music I listen to.
Well, I mean, we agree on country. Painting Pictures by Superstar Pride.
I've not heard that one.
Yeah, it's a really sad song about him growing up in the ghetto. That's not my recommendation. I'm just telling you what I listen to as compared to what y'all listen to. I go from that to George Strait, Troubadour.
That's okay. In the morning at like my 5 a.m. workout, I'm listening to Lizzo.
I've got a Lizzo song on
She gets me pumped up.
Now, I do have on my classic hits, I've got this Fleetwood Mac song that I've fallen in love with recently called Caroline.
Mm-hmm.
Caroline. It's great. I love it. It's
my
awesome.
New recommendation is maybe let Fleetwood Mac sing it.
Lindsey Buckingham. Yeah. So my recommendation is Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy, a film that came out in 2012 starring Gary Oldman, based on the Jean Le Carre novel of the same name.
Say that slower for the rest of us.
Tinker.
Uh-huh.
Taylor. Soldier.
TTS.
Spy.
Yes.
2012. Novel. Based on, written.
I don't need all that.
Jean Le Carre by.
We're good.
Starring Gary Oldman in the lead role. Really, really good. But it's one of those movies that it's a spy movie, but it's a spy movie in the sense that there's action, but it's not action based. It's drama based, it's thriller based, and you have to follow the story. He wouldn't like it because you actually have to you have to think about it. But it's a really good movie because you don't know who's the bad guy and what's happening, and it's classic Jean Le Carre. I don't know if y'all have ever read any of his spy books, but they're really, really good. It's a really well done movie, and I wish they'd make more movies about some of his books. But that's my recommendation.
What's the name of it again?
Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy.
Okay, I've heard about that. That's old, isn't it?
No, Oldman.
Glenn Campbell. That's who Alan Jackson's wife gave the tape to.
Are you serious? No freaking way.
Yeah, Glenn Campbell. That's how Alan Jackson became so famous.
Do you know Glenn Campbell?
No,
I listened to him on the way to work.
Okay,
Glenn Campbell.
You don't.
They're jealous.
You don't know Glenn Campbell? Music?
I would if I heard one.
Who was that? The
Wichita
line?
Lineman.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, I know that one.
Rhinestone Cowboy? Glenn Campbell? Rhinestone Cowboy?
I know that one.
And I drive.
You probably know him. You just don't.
Well, that's a good song.
But now my favorite Glenn Campbell song is Gentle on My Mind. That's my favorite Glenn Campbell song.
He's got some good
ones. Now, that's actually a cover. He didn't write that.
Who wrote it?
I don't know.
I'm sure it was Randy.
None of the words rhyme, though. It's really cool.
Interesting.
It's a song that doesn't rhyme. Go ahead. Recommendation.
All right. So the synopsis of my recommendation is don't do anything that you're supposed to do around the house.
Okay.
The backstory to this is Tuesday night, Wednesday morning is garbage day in the Thompson household. Monday, we were all running late. My son wanted fried chicken, either from Popeye's or from the bakery at Publix or whatever. So my wife goes by and she goes to the grocery store. She gets all this fried chicken and stuff. Well, she ends up getting barbecue baked beans and macaroni and cheese and all this other stuff. So I come home Monday. There's this whole spread. We eat. We put it up. Well, I get up Tuesday morning, and I get to look, and it's like, okay, there's this little container. It looks a lot like this that's been set out, and it looks like potato salad. It's like, you know, okay, they didn't put they didn't throw it away. You know, I'll whatever. So Tuesday night, we come in. We're too busy. Well, Wednesday morning, we get up and say, hey, Mace, you got to get the garbage up. We got to get going. So I go, and I grab this thing of what I thought was potato salad, and I throw it away. Well, little did I know, my wife had bought stuff to make ham and cheese bread, like at Pasquale's back in the day. Well, the little tub of potato salad was a tub of garlic butter that she had setting out to get to room temperature, and I threw it away. So Wednesday night, we're going to watch the Alabama-Auburn basketball game, and kids are going to come over. Nick's going to come over and everything.
Wasn't invited. Go ahead.
It's okay, me either.
Hold on. Never mind. Go ahead. I'm going to talk about that.
Anyway, she is going crazy. She's like, where's the butter? And I'm like, I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
And she's like, the butter was right here. I get thinking, oh, she means a potato salad. It wasn't potato salad. So, like, I offer, like, hey, I don't know where it's at. Do you want me to get some more?
You don't tell her.
Like, I don't tell her. Like, and technically, until this very moment, she doesn't know.
Wonderful.
She knows.
Yeah. I mean, she knew. So, anyway, I go and get it and come back. Well, she makes it, and she's still livid about the butter. She still doesn't know at this point. Well, you had Foo and Cole over, and I brought all them and said, okay, look, she's griping about the butter. This is what really happened. I thought it was potato salad. I threw it away. They die laughing. I think she overheard me.
Yeah, I think she did.
And then she kept asking, oh, it's potato salad, huh? I said, I don't know what you're talking about. So I've denied it up until this very moment, and I've come clean. So my recommendation is don't do anything that you think you need to do, i.e., throw everything away because you think that it's old leftovers.
You think that it's trash.
Yeah.
I saw that on Facebook. That bread looked real good.
Yeah.
So, I would love to have had some. But
well, hold on. Let's get to that. Okay, so yesterday, Marino comes to me and she says, hey, would you like a piece of pound cake?
Hop along.
That I made. I got to get rid of it. I said, sure, I'll take one. And she said, I got you. I got you, Wendy, and David a slice, but I'm not going to give David his because I know if I do, he won't eat it because it's not, you know, because his diet or whatever.
And lifestyle change.
And so.
what diet are you on that you're not eating sweets anymore? Because.
Well, today's his bad day.
Okay.
Well, no, it's tomorrow.
Okay. Oh, so I go over to his room and I'm talking to him about something else and I'm holding my bag of slice of pound cake. And he goes, and he just grabs my slice of pound cake. He's like, that's mine. And then I said, no. He said, where'd you get it? I said, Marino gave it to me. He stood up, walks out of his classroom, goes next door to Marino's classroom and goes, where's mine? You didn't get me one? And she's like, you wouldn't have eaten it if I gave it to you. So going back to your comment about him, if we had invited you, would you have come?
To where?
To Clint's to watch the Auburn basketball game. So, okay. All right. I rest my case.
But
Wednesday night, I got to go to bed, man.
He still wants to.
He wants to be invited.
No. Dude, it's your house. You're the one that didn't invite him. don't talk to me.
I've invited y'all to go to June Jam and
stop. Who invited you?
Maze? Carrie?
Carrie. I think we may be getting in the middle of something.
I think we may be too.
Hey, I did that same thing with my wife. We ate some. She bought this special corn that she had. That she was gonna fix some recipe with. It had spices and all kinds in the bag. You just warm it up in the microwave. We have that stuff at the house. The corn you just warm up. So I found that in the freezer, and there was two or three bags. So we eat all of it. Me and the girls, we loved it. It got time for her to fix her special recipe. Like on Saturday, it was gone, man. I'm like, what are you talking about? Oh, that corn. Yeah, we ate.
We ate it the other night. Yeah, we ate it the other night.
Yeah,
yeah. That was you. Did you get my joke, my stepbrother joke that I made? Okay, you didn't laugh as much as Carrie did.
No,
but you have a room at his house, don't you?
No,
just about.
No,
don't y'all have bunk beds in there?
It's actually a trundle, not a bunk.
Trundle. Yeah. So you sleep on the trundle. You pull the trundle out.
We have a matching set of pajamas that we wear.
And sheets.
Y'all need to make a Christmas card.
We should.
We used to do that when I had three roommates. We'd just have a friend take our faces and edit them onto ridiculous Christmas cards.
One year I was
holding a chicken.
That's what we need. We should do that as a talk or go home.
Yeah, the trundle. That was pretty good.
It's funny that he thinks it's funny.
I like when I can make Murphree laugh like that.
Hey, look.
This is my cheat day today. These are great.
They are fantastic.
Did you make them with a little rum or something in there? Are these rum cinnamon rolls? Because he's feeling good right now. Look, hey, so are you?
Nick's here. Let's pull the.
Surprise, not
so you and Carrie are sleeping up on the bed. He's on the trundle.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so are you going to tell him about the door yesterday after lunch?
The door? What about that?
Remember when I went to grab the door?
I don't know. It happened so fast.
On our way back from lunch, you died laughing. You thought it was the funniest thing ever.
I thought the door was going to be locked. I was going to put my foot. It was like the far side. You know, the far side where the kid's pushing on the door and it says pull.
Yeah.
Because I was going to push on it.
That's my favorite far side.
I was going to push and pull at the same time, and I wasn't expecting it to open.
Here's what happened. He went ahead and spoiled it. But so he and I are walking, and we're laughing about something else. What are we laughing about?
Who knows?
We're laughing about something else. And then what'd you say?
Probably the trundle.
Yeah, probably the trundle. And so this door, and of course, you know, kids these days, they don't give a crap about anything. And so this kid just lets this door shut in our face. And I'm running to go catch it before it closes because we're all going back from lunch going by the library, that door. And I miss it just in time. It closes the second I go, and it locks.
Yeah, that's what was
and
so funny.
It,
yeah,
and don't... I pull it, and I'm like, oh, and I jerk like that.
That's why I started laughing. About
and then it. and then I grab it and I jerk, and you know I'm being dramatic just to make him laugh. And then I open it, and then as soon as I open it, he's like, no. And then he's gonna do the far side bit, and he pushes it back closed, and he puts his foot on it and grabs the handle. So if you're watching this, watch me right now. So he's got it like this, and he's grabbing. Well, he opens it, even though he had closed it again. Gosh. And then it was hilarious because like.
So if I need to break into the school,
he probably broke the door.
But it was like it closed on you. Just
perfect.
Yeah, and you couldn't. It locked. It's just like, you know, it happened to the teacher, and all the kids would have just loved it. You know? But of course, I loved it too because it locked.
He bent over like that, laughing. Like in my face, looking at me, just laughing. Didn't you?
I mean, he's got tears in his eyes right now. About
it. Between the trundle and the far side.
Well, as long as nobody gets hurt, you know.
Yeah.
Well, I would probably still laugh.
I was about to say.
All right,
later.
So.
You would have laughed if he would have got hurt.
He would have. He would have. I'm surprised you didn't
bring it
up.
Somebody could have opened it from another way and hit him right in the head.
That would have been funny. I should have done that on purpose. Just as a bit. Funny. All right. So, guys, thank y'all for tuning in. This is where we're going to take a bow. Morgan, thank you for coming on.
Of course.
First time.
There we go.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We thoroughly enjoyed it. And don't forget to rate, review, whatever. Follow us on all the social medias, Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, @TalkerGoHome or @TalkerGo. Look us up. Follow, subscribe. Send this episode if you enjoyed it. Or any of our other episodes that you enjoy, comedy, to your friends to listen to.
Beer cans on a school bus.
It's the first one I listened to.
Boom, a good one, wasn't it?
It was so good.
What's your favorite episode?
It's the only that one she's listened to is beer, and then this one.
I listened to the pickled egg one.
And the one that
one.
Didn't air.
Did you listen to the pickled egg one?
The one that didn't air was my favorite.
Yeah, the one that didn't air.
That will all have, but not them.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, the pickled eggs episode is pretty good.
Y'all were all over the place.
We
kind of have been today, too.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah,
that's this. If we ever have another podcast where we have to change the name to this one, that's going to be the title of the podcast.
All over the place.
But stay tuned. We've got some exciting news about something that we might be doing different or changing or adding to our. I don't know. We've got ideas that we're going to be playing around with. So stay tuned for that. Don't forget, subscribe, rate, review the podcast on whatever platform you're listening to us on. It helps the podcast. It helps the show. Share it with your friends. Send the text out. Email if you're over the age of 50. Whatever you do, we appreciate it. Don't forget, you can talk
or trundle
or
bake or go home.
Yeah, we got to do that. Oh, that was a good one. Really?
Yeah.
You were in a band?
Why didn't we talk about that?
What was the name of the band?
Flim Flam. So let me tell you the story.
Better than Tree Nuts.
The tree.
She's going to flip you off.
Yeah, she just flipped you off.
What is a band called? The Wing Nuts?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, Flim Flam means to trick somebody into thinking that you're good at what you're doing.
Oh, I thought that's what
I
called.
Oh, okay.
That's just phlegm.
Why are you doing that? We're not on the air anymore.
But we're still recording.
We
are.
P-H-L-E-G-M, I think.
Yeah, that's how
you Ours was F-L-I-M, F-L-A-M.
Flim Flam.
Yeah.
I love, that's awesome. We should start a band.
Yeah, we should. We don't know how to play anything. That's a great idea. Is that the changes we're going to make?
David, you get the triangle.
Yes. No. So, look.
Bongo drums.
It's not a change. It's not a change.
If Murphree plays the bongo drums, please play the bongo drums. No.
We
just come out.
Open mic poetry and let my...
And yeah, everybody.
Yeah. I don't like the world anymore.
I ate all the corn.
Too much corn.
It had roasted red peppers.
It did.
I don't remember eating any corn.
And it does not digest.
Hey.
Oh, it does not.
Yeah, I know that.
You ate the whole bag.
Cologuard knows it. The Cologuard.
Oh my gosh, that was hilarious.
Isn't it funny how that's become a thing? It's just a thing now.
Cologuard.
Yeah.
Hey, when you asked a question about were you on board with something before it got big? Just what you should have said. You're like, I was on Cologuard before that SNL skit.
I know my niece's husband was. He invented it, you know, in Afghanistan. He was on board. Hey, y'all are invited. June Jam and Justin Miss.
Okay. Hey, we have a meeting at 12:45.